celebrate 6 years. Yes. See? Yeah, because see, when you've gone through some stuff, you learn to celebrate every year of grace, every year that God has given you in the new. And even with that, I had to learn how to embrace the new with my husband, because I had a lot of stuff for baggage and anger and frustration and stuff like that. But God shifted me, healed my heart and my mind, so that now stuff that used to make me just fly all the way off the handle, I know how to deal with it. Amen.
Amen.
But today, right quick, if you would, go with me to Isaiah 43. We're in a season of the new.
Thank you, God.
In my book, in my new book, Now Is Your Time.
Yes.
Let me tell y'all something.
Let's start right there.
Yes.
Yeah. I have one of the keys in there says, embrace the new without apologies. And that has been a problem with a whole lot of people. That God will give you a new start. And all of a sudden, you get there and you don't understand how to function in it. We don't know. And so what we do is we revert back to the old because it was familiar, even though it was frustrating.
Come on. Jesus.
Even though it was frustrating, it's familiar, so we settle for it. But my prayer is, Lord, help us to embrace the new. Help us to learn how to walk in this new season. Help us to learn how to talk and to move in this new place.
Yeah.
My God. Isaiah 43 verse 18 says, forget the former things.
Yeah.
I'm reading from the NIV, I think, but I'll read it from this one. Says, remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing now. Somebody say now.
Now.
It shall. Somebody say shall.
Shall.
That means it surely will.
Yep.
It surely will spring forth. Shall you not know it? Oh God, it doesn't feel comfortable, so that Minister Chris, Romans 12. And I'm going to read this out of the Amplified Version. It says, "Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies, dedicating all of yourselves, set apart, as a living sacrifice, holy and well-pleasing to God, which is your rational, logical, intelligent act of worship."
Gee.
Oh my God, he broke it all the way down.
Gee.
"And do not be conformed to this world any longer with its superficial values and customs. But be ye transformed." Somebody say transformed.
Transformed.
"And progressively changed as you mature spiritually." Okay. Let me stop right there. "But be transformed and progressively changed." That sounds like a process to me.
Yeah.
See, I used to hate going through, you know, I wanted it quick. You know, that was back in the day. I ain't got time for that. I need everything quick. But when I realized that the blessing was in the process, because see, the process served two folds. Because in the process teaches you and it matures you, and then it also prepares you for the promise. Oh, God. See, I wanted the promise and didn't know what to do with it when I got it. But if I had submitted myself to the process, then I would have been well equipped to handle that thing. Oh, God. See, I'm talking to myself. I ain't talking to y'all. Y'all some super Christians. Y'all always had it all right. Y'all good, though. Bless God. I'm sorry, but the process really brought me through. He says progressively change. Now, we look at change and transform. Sometimes we use those words like interchangeably. We use them like they just, we can just do that. You cannot do that. Because when some change is quick, transformation takes a process. It's a little bit longer.
Yeah.
Transformation is taking you from one thing and creating something totally different, and you probably can't go back because the thing that you left is dead.
Yeah, now.
Oh yeah, just like that caterpillar. That caterpillar has to die to become a butterfly. Yeah. And I don't think that butterfly can go back to being a caterpillar. You just can't do it. But see, when you just want to change, it's easy for you to think, you know what, when the heat is on, when it's going to get tough, I'll just go back to what I used to do. Oh, that ain't nobody. Am I the only one that used to think that? Look, that's my plan B. I can go back over here and I'm good. Plan B. Plan B has robbed so many of us out of our promise.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God. Plan B. I used to live my life off of Plan B because I didn't think I could. I was worthy enough for the plan.
Right.
So I'd be like, oh, it's okay. I'll be comfortable over here. No, the devil is a lie. I am a king's kid, and this is mine. Yeah. It doesn't matter where I come from. Just know where I'm going.
Hey.
Oh, yeah. It doesn't matter what they said about me. I knew I was a teenage mother. I knew what I'd gone through. I know all that. And God knew it from the beginning. He knew what I was going through, where I was going to be today. Like El said, he already knew that thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
So now, I just have to embrace the process. Somebody say, I'm embracing my process. See, the moment you get it in your mind that it's going to be transformation over change, you're going to see God move like never before. Because all throughout the process, you start seeing little clues that God is working on your behalf. Oh, my God, my God. Let me finish this one out. It says, progressively change as you mature spiritually by the renewing of your mind, focusing on godly values and ethical attitudes. Do you not hear that? So that you may prove for yourselves what the will of God is. For yourself. For yourself.
Yeah.
Tell y'all something. Tell me honest. Stop running behind every preacher, every prophet, by one good word. You don't know what their life is. Some folks leave their own pastors, the pastors that have labored with them, to go run up behind some. Stop it. When are you going to take what you have and use it? When are you going to say, okay, this is enough for right now. I'm going to stand on this right here, and I'm going to watch God move like never before. I'm not going to spend another dollar. I'm not going to hold my God. See, I'm telling you,
my.
When folk know that you're vulnerable, they play on that. Pay for a prophecy, the devil is a lie.
That's good. That's good right there. Amen.
Going in all these different programs, the one that you went through, you didn't do nothing with that one. What you think this one gonna do? But put you set your further and further behind. I'm not saying that you're not supposed to do something. You're supposed to continue learning and growing and things like that, but you need to do something with what you already have. That's a part of the process. But just because you think Sister Sally in Miami look big and she got a big old following, that's not going to make your process any faster. Do what you need to do from the Root Project. You just can get through that. Let us see that through first, and then you move and progress. But you're running because we want change quickly, and we don't want to be processed. If you really got what you needed, you'll be able to do the same thing that Sister So-and-so do. The same thing that I had the ability to do. I poured it in you. I gave it to you. I gave it.
Oh, my God.
Amen.
Amen.
And not even jealous about it, but I want you to be able to go and grow. Do what it is that the Lord has called you to do. That's not seeing it. When you go forward, I'm standing moving forward. I'm going on. So if I'm moving on now, you still in the same place. Now, something wrong. Now, what did I didn't do something right. Something ain't right. But see, that's the problem. People will come to you, and they don't want to learn from you, sis.
Come on.
Spiritually mature, that's what the word says right here. They want a leech. Let me see what I can just suck out of you. Do you understand that this came with a price? This came with a price. Yeah, this is not juicy juice. This is a real thing. You don't know what to do with it. You're going to mess yourself up. This ain't something that you just play with. I had to, there was some suffering. There was some crushing. There was some rejection. See, what you're going through now, you're like, God, get me out of this. No, he's getting the oil out of you. The devil looking like, I don't have nothing to do with this.
Right.
See, he says,
Jeez.
So that you may prove yourselves that the will of God, what the will of God is, that which is good and acceptable and perfect in his plan and purpose for you. I just said for me.
For me.
How many of you just want the purpose of God fulfilled in your life? I love living a life of purpose. Even though I don't fully understand the totality of my whole purpose, if somebody told you they know the totality of it, then, you know, something ain't right. Because you're not God.
That's right.
You do not know the fullness of your purpose.
My God.
You know that God is working. You have an idea of what you're called to do. But as long as you live, you will always have the opportunity to unveil more stuff. God is going to release, and the Lord, he's going to always give you more. Next year, what God gives you, what he revealed to you about you, will be nothing compared to what you're seeing.
Hallelujah.
As long as you continue to live and grow, God, he has a way of giving us what we need at the time we're able to handle it. That's why you need to mature. Because as long as you stay in a child, because see, staying in a childlike state, it keeps you in a place where you're not accountable. But the more you grow, accountability has to show up. But we're in this season, your stuff, everything that you've been praying for, even that healing, even in here today, some of you have so much on your heart. It's not about money. It's not about houses or cars. It's the stuff that you've gone through. You just want God to heal your heart. And that's what he's going to do. Because as soon as your healing come through, guess what? It goes in a book. It goes in a play. It goes, oh my God. It goes in a movie. Your healing. See, I don't allow the enemy to do anything to me without paying me, because the Bible says he's supposed to pay you back. Seven. Come on now. Seven times. So I want my stuff. Job chapter 8. We're almost done. Job chapter 8, verse 5. And this was Job's friend. He was trying, you know, Job's friend was trying to encourage him. I don't know, you know, how much they knew to encourage Job, because they didn't go through what he went through. But, right, they can only do as much as they can. So, verse 5 says, if you would diligently, he's telling this to Job, if you would diligently seek God and implore the compassion and favor of the Almighty, this is Amplified, then if you are pure and upright, surely now he will awaken for you and restore your righteous place. Though your beginning, my God. See, y'all don't want to talk about this here. Though your beginning was insignificant, yet your end will greatly increase. The Bible says, let's go, take me to the King James. Your end will greatly increase. Your end will greatly increase. Your end will greatly increase. Oh my God, I don't know about y'all, but my focus is, the Bible says, don't look at those things. You can't focus on the stuff from the past. That's what Paul said. He says, press towards the mark. Oh God, look at here. Though thy beginning was small, yet thy latter end shall greatly increase. See, let me tell you something. He told, Job's friend says, if you would diligently seek God and implore the compassion and favor. Hey, go back up to verse 5. Go back up to verse 5 of the King James. If thou would seek unto God betimes, thy supplication to the Almighty. Come on. If thou were pure and upright. See, that people that was telling Job, you said you was pure, you was upright, you had all the righteousness and stuff like that. Come on now. If this God is really, you know, as powerful as you say he is, then all you need to do is repent. All you need to go and talk to him. Turn your head to him. That's what he says. All you got to do is reach out to him. He says, if thou were pure and upright, surely now he would awake for thee and make the habitation of thy righteousness prosperous. Some of you have been too quiet. You need to go back to God and tell him, look, Lord, now, I repented for all that stuff I did. Lord, if you just help me up out of here, no matter what, I'm going to God. He says, look, if you're still in the right place, righteousness, right standing, if you're still in the right standing with God, then he's going to make you prosperous. Oh, my God, my God, my God. See, if you've been walking with God and trusting him for any period of time, then right now, your shift is happening.
Thank you, God.
Right now, your shift is happening.
Right now.
See, whether you see it or not, you can't see what's going on underneath the ground where plants are growing. You can't see that. But all you know is something just it shall spring forth.
Yeah.
And you're like, wow, here it is. Oh my God, it's a miracle. This ain't been working for the longest. And you say it's a miracle, but this thing has been working. And so what, just because you don't see it doesn't mean you stop believing.
That's right. That's it.
But that's what we do. If we don't see God doing it, well, I guess if we get like Job, Job went in. Well, he ran his mouth so bad. Y'all go back and read it. And the man says, look, Job, now, come on now. This is the same God you used to talk about all the time. And you said you was all that. If you still all that, then you can go to him. He gonna forgive you. And he's going to restore you. My God, my God. God is working.
Yes, he is.
On some of you, your prayers right now. See, the thing about a shift, it takes place and you won't even know it.
Thank you.
You won't even know it. But that's why you have to learn to embrace the new. Okay, well, I'm in a different place right now. Okay, embrace it. Okay, Lord, help me. Help my mind. Help my body. Because see, the thing about it, there's something working for my good. I just can't see it. I can't feel it right now. But God, I know it's working on my behalf. So Lord, right now, I just ask that you just help me. Help right on my tongue, God. Help me to stay focused, Lord. Don't let the people get me off course, God. Help me, Lord, God. Even though, Lord, they're talking about me. Help me, Lord, God, to walk through this. Even though, oh, they fired you off your job. While the shift is taking place. My God, the Bible says in Galatians chapter 6, verse 9, and let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. See, that's the thing right there. You know it's going to come. What you believe in God for is coming if you just don't give up. But see, you give up and you don't sow for it no more. You give up and you don't practice anymore. You don't read up on whatever you believe in for anymore. You know, you're like, well, I've been single for 30 years now. Ain't no sense in me. Well, that's you then. If that was me, I'd still be acting like a wife. I'd still be preparing myself. Because, oh, he gonna show up. Even if he have to show up with his false teeth, he's showing up. Because if you don't wait 30 years, you know what I'm saying? You might as well keep waiting, just stay prepared.
Yeah.
Don't let it pass you by. But see, we pray for a move. We pray for God to move on situations and to bring us out of the old things. But are you prepared for the new?
Jeez.
That's good.
See, we've spent so much time complaining about the old until all that time we could have been preparing for the promise.
Yes.
That's how the enemy gets us. He gets us to a place where we're not prepared for the thing that we've been praying for.
Amen.
And now the blessing feels like a curse.
Wow.
That's heavy. Are you prepared for what you've been praying for? Are you just complaining, God, get me out of this situation, and you ain't learned nothing? It's time for us to get in a posture to receive. When I used to play basketball, I don't remember how it was now, but I'm telling you, there was a posture. Because if that ball come your way, you need to be sure that you get it. You need to be ready. You, your eyes. The coach,
yes.
Tell you what they say, keep your eyes. If you take your eyes off the ball, then you're going to see that. You're going to see stars. Then the other team can steal and take it and, you know. There you go.
Right.
And you can't be mad. But the attention without getting caught up.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Can you handle the fact that you're now, you before you wasn't the topic of conversation, but now they're all talking about you? Yeah.
That's good.
See, can you handle? See, you gotta embrace that new. Because see, stuff like that used to make me cringe and I would just go back in my shell. But when I realized that as a African-American woman, that I can't afford to run back in my shell because there's too much at stake. There's too many other women. There's too many other people that need your voice, that need what you have. There's so many folk that say if she don't make it, then I know I can't do it. So you cannot revert back anymore. You can't revert back.
Come on.
It's time to come all the way out. Shame, we're afraid to be talking about. I'm telling you, on this new level and this new season that you're about to enter into, it's gonna cause you to, you know, people are gonna be able to see you because the spotlight is on you. The spotlight is that of Jesus Christ. The anointing is upon your life. And so they're wondering, how did she get the position? Who put her here? What that she don't qualify? See, they don't know you suffer for it. Yeah. You suffer for it. And some of it wasn't that found UAFSU either. You suffer through the hard knocks of life. You suffer through it. And God says, okay, there you go. Can you handle that kind of attention? See, in Lodabar, nobody was checking for you.
Nobody.
See, they ain't care about you over there, Lodabar. See, Lodabar is in a place where you didn't know who you were. You didn't have nothing. You were just dead to the spirit of Christ in your life. But now that you are awake and you are alive and well, come on, Mikhail. I'm done. Now, see, I know there's a song, but I always say the wrong person, so I'm not going to say it. I heard this song before.
Go ahead.
What's the name of it, L?
Go ahead.
And who is it? I thought it was Drake, but it's not.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
See, before there was what? They weren't checking for you, but now they all on you. What is that?
What? Oh, yeah.
See, y'all know my daughter. I ain't never seen her. But I'm telling you something. That resonated with me. Because, see, back in the day, they was led by me.
They weren't checking.
They want me.
They couldn't see you.
But the thing about it is that.
That's good right there.
And then have you ever been in a place where people tried to come and they tried to handle you the way they left you? Baby! No, no, no. I'm not the same person that you love. No, no, no. See, that's the thing. They went to the tomb looking for Jesus and he wasn't there. Didn't I tell you that I wasn't gonna stay down? Didn't I tell you yours. Breeze, that's why I gave you the mic this morning. God put pressure on that thing. Whatever it is, that thing that's trying to come at you, no, you turn around and you chase it. See, that's the thing right there. When people used to try to bully me at school, oh no, okay. Now I'm about to turn around and bully you. Even though I probably was so scared of, but maybe I could let you see me shake. Because see, the thing you.